In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the quaternary structure of protein. Now, what happens? Some proteins, they have more than one polypeptide chains, right? They have more than one polypeptide chains. So, let us take example of hemoglobin A, that is adult hemoglobin. Now, we know that in adult hemoglobin, there are two alpha chains and two beta chains. So, here total four chains are there, four chains, right? And each chain, in such cases when more than one polypeptide chains are found, each chain, it is known as subunit. So, what happens in hemoglobin? That all of these four chains, they aggregate together and then they carry out their biological function. Biological function, that is transport of oxygen. So, diagrammatically, suppose this is the one alpha chain, this is second alpha chain, then this is one beta chain and this is second beta chain. So, here what happened? All these four chains, they are aggregating together and then they are carrying out biological function. So, once they aggregate, there must be some kind of spatial relationship occurs between all these four chains. This is a spatial relationship. Spatial relationship. So, this spatial relationship, it is known as quaternary structure. So, what happens if more than one polypeptide chains, they aggregate to form one functional protein, right? Then the spatial relationship between all these polypeptide chains or subunit, it is referred to as a quaternary structure. This is the definition of quaternary structure. So, now I will write down definition of the quaternary structure. What is quaternary structure? It is if more than one polypeptide chains or subunits aggregates to form one functional protein, the spatial relationship between these polypeptide chains is referred to as a quaternary structure. I hope the definition of this quaternary structure, it is clear to you. Okay. Now, as we had seen that there is a some kind of spatial relationship, they are acting like a one unit. So, that means there must be certain stabilization forces in this protein, right? So, what are the stabilization forces for this quaternary structure? So, stabilization forces. Remember, in case of quaternary structure, all the stabilization forces are the non-covalent type. So, what are these stabilization forces? The first one is the hydrogen bond. Then we have hydrophobic interactions, and then third one is the electrostatic interaction. This electrostatic interaction, it is also called as ionic bond. And all these stabilization forces I had explained you in my video of tertiary structure of protein. Now, in relation to this quaternary structure, there is two important terminology that we need to understand. The first one is the homomeric protein, and second one is the heteromeric protein. Now, what do we mean by homomeric protein? See, we know that in quaternary structure, there are more than one polypeptide chain, but it is possible that all these protein chains, they are identical. Okay. So, when we have identical subunits or identical polypeptide chain, we can call such protein as a homomeric protein. One example is the LDH5, lactate dehydrogenase 5 subtype isoenzyme. It is homomeric protein. Why? Because it has four chains. So, of course, it has quaternary structure and all the four chains are of the M variety or M chains. So, it is this M chain subunit. This is also M, this is also M. So, all four chains are identical. So, that's why we can call this LDH5 as a homomeric protein. Heteromeric protein, it is opposite of this homomeric protein. It is different subunits. And we had already covered this example. That is, example is this adult hemoglobin. Why? Because it is more than one type of subunit. So, here example is adult hemoglobin. Now, what is the significance of this quaternary structure that we are going to discuss next? So, what is the significance of this quaternary structure? See, again, I will explain you with the help of this example, adult hemoglobin. We know that in adult hemoglobin, there are four subunits or four polypeptide chains. These two are alpha, these two are beta, and there is some kind of spatial relationship. And this spatial relationship, it is known as quaternary structure, right? Now, hemoglobin, its function is transport of oxygen. So, how this quaternary structure helps in the transport of oxygen? See, this alpha subunit or any subunit, when it binds with this oxygen, this is oxygen, when it binds with the oxygen, then what this alpha subunit will do? It influences this beta chain, this alpha chain, and this beta chain. And that influence is in the positive way. That means it increases the affinity of this beta, alpha, and beta towards the oxygen. So, here I can say that binding of oxygen to one subunit increases the affinity of other polypeptide chains towards the oxygen. So, here this binding of oxygen is the type of influence on this other chain, and this type of influence is the cooperativity. So, here we can see that binding of one subunit is influencing the binding of this oxygen towards the other subunit. Let's take up one more example, which is mostly seen in the enzyme. In the enzyme, what happens? There are three or four or like multiple subunits are there. And here I am taking example of two subunit protein. So, we have two subunits. Suppose this is subunit A and this is subunit B, right? Now, what happens? This subunit B is involved in the binding of substrate. So, here we have substrate binding site. And subunit A, it is involved in binding of regulatory protein. So, regulatory protein binds over here. So, what happens? Once regulator, it binds over here, then this A subunit, it influences this B subunit and it modifies its affinity for the binding of substrate. So, if this is a positive regulator, then the binding of substrate will be increased. If this is negative regulator, the binding of substrate over here will get decreased. So, this kind of relationship or this kind of influence, it is known as regulatory influence. Right? So, you can see over here that quaternary structure is not directly involved in the biological activity of protein, but it is influencing the biological activity of protein, right? So, significance of quaternary structure is that it influences the biological activity of the protein. And two major type of influences are, one is cooperativity and second one is the regulatory influence. So, this is all about the quaternary structure of the protein. If you have any query or confusion, please write it down in the comment section below. Thank you.